telescopes looming to target. Telescope slew complete.
Just getting set up. Let me take a few darks. Now, I'm going to take some darks. Three seconds. Game 40. Histogram 0 to 75. Save. Enable. Start building an image. Hi, Dory. Yeah, I'm just trying out that little Zenith Star 61. I have the Zenith Star flat field device in, and I also have the focal reducer in. So it looks like the stars at the very corners are better corrected than they were without the field flattener. I should be taking a nap. I worked all day. See what happens when I go to 5 seconds. Let me change the affinity. Okay. Good. So I'm right now the scope's running at about F4.4. And this is a 5 second exposure. I think I have the sharpness set to about 50. Okay. Let me set up to automate grabbing some images. Preferences, auto capture, desktop, PNG, time frame. How about every 30 seconds? And how about grabbing, say, 400, apply, okay. And then capture, auto capture. So now I have it auto capturing. Surprised nobody else is on tonight. Maybe everybody's watching television. To try go into a longer exposure. I'm going to stop the auto stack. Let's go trigger mode. Oh, come on. Why will it not go to trigger mode? Digital binning 2. And where is conversion gain? Conversion gain is on high. Okay. And then I'm looping with 10 seconds. Gain at 40. Welcome, guest. Damn it. It's 10 seconds, gain 40 out of 160. Let me go back to capturing images. I forgot when I stopped the camera and started it, I lost all of that. Again, this is a 61 millimeter scope, 2.1 inch. And I'm running at about f4.4. Not a bad little view. I was just concerned that I wouldn't be able to use the focal reducer and the field flattener at the same time. And it looks like it is possible. No filters tonight because there's no moon in the way. Yeah, that they do look quite good. It's in the west right now. Let's see what else is in the west before I go over to Orion.
Telescopes flew into target.
Going to the double
telescope slew
double
complete.
Cluster. Let me stop the stacking. Hey, well, yeah, I just moved over to the double cluster. Not quite centered. Yeah, I'm just trying that little small scope again tonight. South is the wrong way, so I gotta flip north and south. Yeah, the field flattener and the focal reducer together seems like they're working pretty well. Trying to get the I got a 10-second exposure going now. Because I have the low gain. I'm only at gain 40 out of 160. Maybe a little bit high. Get there and into a sink. Yeah, Brian had suggested that I get the field flattener because he said that without it, then there is some distortion on the outer edge of the field. And so I ordered it. It came in New Year's Eve. And of course, it hasn't been clear since then.
Telescope synced.
Okay, so I'm synced right between the two. Let me turn off the crosshair. I'm not using a filter tonight. It'd be interesting to see if I need one later. Yeah, I'm pleased with this little 61 millimeter. It's performing well. Let me get my hand out of the way. Interesting to see if I get yeah. This is a 61. Yes. 2.1 inch. This is single. I haven't done any stacking with this.
Telescopes looming to target.
This man, I went to the
telescope slew complete.
The Sol Nebula. Let's see if I can pull any of it out. It was really windy all day today. I mean, there's some nebulosity there, but there's not a whole lot. Let's see. Stop. Let me loop at 15. Color adjust. 1.2 on the gamma. I think I may need a filter. Yeah, they are quite good. Let me do a do another white balance. I mean, that's the Sol Nebula. I'm going to try stacking and see if it comes. I mean, it's definitely there, but it's this is where I think a filter would help. Yeah, well, I agree. The worst thing you can do is overclean optics, because the scratches you can put in the coatings can cause more light scatter than the little bit of dust that's on there. Try going with a little bit longer exposure. Let's see. Stop. Let me go to 20. Yep. I'm going for 20 seconds to see if I can pull out anything more out of this. Yeah, the histogram just shifted a little bit to the right. Oh, you got the horse head up? Be going to the eastern horizons shortly. I'm almost kind of weighed up, so I'm pretty close to the meridian right now. Nothing at a bigger aperture wouldn't help. Let's see. Yeah, it was a fun night the other night, doing. So there's the comet. The comet's.
Telescopes looming to target.
Going to M40.
Telescopes loo complete.
M34 coming up. Let's see. Okay. Yep. I agree, Will. That's okay, well, this is M4034. Let's see.
Telescopes looming to target.
Rotate.
Telescopes loo complete.
Let's wait till the next refresh. 2 seconds. California Nebula. Okay, single frame. So let's do some average stacking. That's not bad. A bright star to the right center is magnitude 4. What can I do to tweak this to make it look a little better? Okay, I got a 5 second dark apply, but I'm at a 20 second exposure. Very nice. Okay, what, Billy? After this, I'm going to move over to the Pleiades and see what I can get. Let me see if I can get a little bit, go a little bit longer exposure and see what happens. Right now I'm at 30 sec, 20 seconds. I'm going to go to 30. Start looping. In the first of the 30-second exposures now. Thirty may be too much. I may have pushed it going too much with 30. Okay. Now let me do some average stacking now. Okay. The dimensions on the California Nebula. It's 2 degrees by 3/4 of a degree. Yeah. 2/3 of a degree by 2 degrees. Okay. God, if it was easy to put a filter on, I'd try a filter. It's not easy to add one in right now. Well, I think I'm gonna move over to the Pleiades.
Telescope slewing to target. Telescope slew complete.
Okay, did I stop stacking? Yes, I did. Okay, here comes the first. All right. Let me do a white balance. Do some average stacking. Okay, it's only 7 o'clock. Wow. Where is the comet? Okay, comet, comet, comet. Oh, the comet's right above the Pleiades. Okay.
Telescopes looming to target.
Okay, is it still in the slits?
Telescopes slew complete.
Yes, it is. Okay. Went over to Comet Garrels, 64P Garrels. And I think that little fuzzy dot right in the center is going to be it. Wait till the next exposure. Coming up in 5 seconds. There's the comet right in the center. Let me do a white balance. Okay, white balance. That little fuzz right in the center is comet 64P. Let me put some text up. Bingo. Right there. And according to Sky Tools, right now it's magnitude 11.1. A satellite just went through the field of view. I'm going to move over to Werdenin. Werdenin's actually gotten fainter. It's down to magnitude 5.2, but it's gotten smaller. It was almost 2 degrees across with the coma. Now it's about a half degree across with the coma. I guess it's receding from us. So let's. Let's go to 46P. Evening, Simon.
Telescopes looming to target.
Okay.
Telescope SLU complete.
Going to Comet 46P. Wait till the next refresh without looking at the gnome. Okay. I don't know why that sky looks so white over there. Okay. Let's do a white balance. Let me reduce the exposure time. Stop. Let me go from 30 seconds down to about 20. I'm going to loop a 20 second exposure. Hey, Rusty. It's been cloudy and rainy for the last 10 days since Christmas Eve. It's been terrible. Let's see, this is 46P. Wordenin. We get liquid snow. Forty-six P. According to Sky, it's magnitude 5.2. Hey, Bob. The size on the comet has reduced. It's now about 34 arc minutes in size, about a half a degree. At one point, it was almost 2 degrees across. Tonight, I'm using the Zenith Star 61, the Zenith Star 61 Field Flattener, the Mallencam Ritchie Cretion Focal Reducer, and the DS-10C TEC. And it looks like the Field Flattener is doing what it was supposed to do. It's cleaned up the corners a lot compared to what it was without the Field Flattener. Temperature here right now is 55 Fahrenheit. It's supposed to get down to about 43, 44 in the morning. This little scope with the field flattener and the focal reducer, I'm getting about a 4.5 degree field of view. Brock was saying it was he got up real early this morning and drove into Ottawa, and he said he had it was pretty cool this morning when he drove in. How high up are they? Oh, that would be. Hi, Nick. I am how I'm altitude. I'm 30 degrees up. This may be too low to go to.
Telescopes looming to target.
But what the heck?
Telescopes loo complete.
Oh, it's called my neighbor's tree nebula. Gee, the comet between two galaxies. What is that? I guess I'm picking up the power line too. You can see it's moving away from the tree. That's a big. That's a big Susanqua right outside the observatory. We're only 20 degrees up. It's amazing that that tree is fairly close. I want to say that's 25 feet outside the observatory. Then you got the power line going back to my house and my neighbor's house. And the two galaxies are being bisected by the power line. You'll see every refresh, they kind of move a little bit higher. Yeah, that's too low. I have to go higher up in the sky. It's a the power line going along. It runs parallel to my property line along the east side of the property line. There's a pole at the southeast corner of the lot, and then there's a pole right behind my house. And the power line runs parallel to the fence line. And whenever I look towards the east, I generally hit the power line. Let's see, I gotta get. Let me go over to Auriga. 36. I'm gonna go right between 36 and 38.
Telescopes looming to target.
That should be away from the power line.
Telescopes loo complete.
Okay, no refresh coming up. Oh, coffee, keep me awake. Let's see, the three, what are the three open clusters in Auriga? 36, 38. Oh, and 37th outside. Okay. I think that's M38 at the bottom. Turn the labels off. I think that's NGC 1907, right above. I think I have the orientation right. Trying to it's amazing how good this looks. The stars are so crisp. I think that's M38 at the bottom. Let me get a DSS image, see if I can confirm that.
Operation completed.
Yeah, I think it is. I gotta try to. Oh, I gotta take this description off. That's not the comet. Let me go to a shorter exposure and see if I can move that cluster to the center. And then do a sync stop. Let's go to about a 5 second loop. Bring up the crosshairs. I want to bring it up to the center. So which sieve? And get that cluster towards the center a little bit better. Like for 15 seconds. I think I have. Yeah, that's M38 right in the center.
Telescope synced. Telescope slewing to target.
Okay.
Telescope slew complete.
Slew to another. What is this called? This is the Fuchs Nebulae. I don't see it. Maybe I synced on the wrong cluster.
Telescope slew into target. Telescope slew complete.
Went to a star at the corner of Auriga. What is this? This is Almanath. Okay, let me go to a short exposure. Yeah, I'm not synced right. Stop. Loop. Hopefully I'm synced on the right star this time. I think I had the wrong cluster. I don't think that was M38. I think it was a different cluster. Okay. Sync.
Telescope synced. Telescope slew into target.
We're moving over.
Telescope slew complete.
IC410, diffuse nebula. So let's go back to a longer exposure. Loop. and see if anything shows up. Let me raise the black. Lower the white. What is it supposed to be? That's supposed to be. IC410. What is IC410? IC410. The Tadpole Nebula. Okay. Well, it is barely there. Let me see if I can average stack it if it gets any better. Maybe a filter would help. And then right near it is the flaming star. I might go to the flaming star next to see if I can pull up anything. Go back to fit to window. There's the full field. I mean, there is some nebulosity there, but it's not very impressive. Oh, my neighbor just started this car up. Getting some color in that nebulosity. I wonder if a longer exposure would help. Try to look, go to 30 seconds. I'm gonna push to see if I can see any of the tadpoles in the Tadpole Nebula. A little 5 second dark is not cutting it. I see a hint of red. Yes, I do. There is a hint of red just to the right of that row of stars. I'm gonna do one more of these. Let me, and then I'm gonna stop this recording and start another recording, just in case it decides to bomb out. And I've captured 120 images so far. Okay, so let me.